First, we will chant the Sanskrit for number 6. Mumukshu prema baspogam.
Mumukshu prema baspogam.
Virahait kantya katara.
Virahait kantya katara.
Rajatam arhayam chakre.
Rajatam arhayam chakre.
Kritasana parigraham.
Kritasana parigraham.
Mumuchu prema baspogam.
Mumuchu prema baspogam.
Virahait kantya katara.
Virahait kantya katara.
Rajatam atayam chakre.
Rajatam atayam chakre.
Kritasana parigraham.
Kritasana parigraham.
Mumukshu prema baspogam.
Mumukshu prema baspogam.
Virahait kantya katara.
Virahait kantya katara.
Rajatam arhayam chakre.
Rajatam arhayam chakre.
Kritasana parigraham.
Kritasana parigraham.
Mumuchu prema baspogam.
Mumuchu prema baspogam.
Virahait kantya katara.
Virahait kantya katara.
Raja tamarhaya chakre.
Raja tamarhaya chakre.
Kritasana parigraham.
Kritasana parigraham.
Mumukshu prema baspaudham.
Mumukshu prema baspaudham.
Viraho kantya katarah.
Viraho kantya katarah.
Raja tamarhaya chakre.
Raja tamarhaya chakre.
Kritasana parigraha.
Kritasana parigraha.
Mumukshu prema baspaudham.
Mumukshu prema baspaudham.
Mumukshu emanated. Prema,
prema,
affectionate,
affectionate.
Baspa ogam.
Baspa ogam.
Emotional tears.
Emotional tears.
Viraha.
Viraha.
Separation.
Separation.
Aukantya.
Aukantya.
Anxiousness.
Anxiousness.
Katara.
Katara.
Being aggrieved.
Being
Raja.
Raja.
King Yudhisthira.
King Yudhisthira.
Tam,
tam
unto him, Vidura.
Unto him, Vidura.
Arhayam chakre.
Arhayam chakre.
Offered.
Offered.
Krita.
Krita.
Performance of.
Performance of.
Asana.
Asana.
Sitting accommodation.
Sitting accommodation.
Parigraham.
Parigraham.
Arrangement of.
Arrangement of.
Translation. Due to anxieties and long separation, they all cried out of affection. King Yudhisthira then arranged to offer sitting accommodations and a reception. There is no purport. I'll read the next verse. Tam buktavantam ishrantam asinam sukham asane prashrayavanato raja prahatesham na shrinvatam. Translation. After Vidura ate sumptuously and took sufficient rest, he was comfortably seated. Then the king began to speak to him, and all who were present there listened. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. King Yudhisthira was expert in reception also, even in the case of his family members. Vidura was well received by all the family members by exchanges of embrace and obeisances. After that, bathing and arrangements for a sumptuous dinner were made, and then he was given sufficient rest. After finishing his rest, he was offered a comfortable place to sit, and then the king began to talk about all happenings, both family and otherwise. That is the proper way to receive a beloved friend or even an enemy. According to Indian moral codes, even an enemy received at home should be so well received that he will not feel any fearful situation. An enemy is always afraid of his enemy, but this should not be so when he is received at the home by his enemy. This means that a person, when received at home, should be treated as a relative. So what to speak of a family member like Vidura, who was a well-wisher for all the members of the family? Thus, Yudhisthira Maharaj began to speak in the presence of all the family members. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitayena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Bandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Kurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Ragnatam Vitam Tam Sajivam Sanitam Savadutam Parjana Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishaka Nitamscha He Krishna Karana Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Okay, so we're hearing how Vidura returned to Hastinapur after many years.
So we can see Vidura returned to Hastinapur for many years.
What about the Nepali devotees? Okay, they're going.
Nepali devotees also, there will be separate translation.
The separate translation. Okay. So Vidura had been driven out of the palace by the son of Dhritarashtra, Duryodhan, and he had gone to visit all the holy place. And after the battle of Kurukshetra, Dhritarashtra's sons were all killed in the battle, and Dhritarashtra was left in Hastinapur and taken care of by the Pandavas.
在库尔之野战争中, Dhritarashtra的100个儿子都被杀, Dhritarashtra就住在王宫里得到宽达五兄弟的照顾。
So Maharaj Yudhisthira, he's the oldest of the five Pandavas, he has come to receive Vidura. And it is described how they received, how Vidura was received by everyone.
在这里今天这个描述了，就维多拉是如何受待每个人的盛情款待。
It mentioned how they embraced each other and offered obeisances to each other.
这里描述了他们互相拥抱，互相顶拜。
Just like when Krishna would meet the Pandavas, he would offer his obeisances to Maharaj Yudhisthira and Bhima.
就像 Krishna 遇到班达瓦五兄弟的时候， Krishna 向 Yudhisthira 和 Bhima 顶拜。
Because Krishna was younger than Bhima and Maharaj.
因为 Krishna 比 Bhima 和 Yudhisthira 年幼。
And then Krishna would embrace Arjuna because they were the same age.
然后 Krishna 拥抱 Arjuna， 因为他 Krishna 和 Arjuna 同龄。
And then the Nakula and Sahadev, they would come and they would offer obeisances to Lord Krishna.
Nakula and Sahadev, 他们这个攀爬五兄弟的后面的两 Nakula Sahadev， 他们过来顶拜 Krishna.
And this way they would respect each other.
就这样，他们互相的表示了尊敬。
So Srila Prabhupada is commenting on the nice etiquette shown by Maharaj Yudhisthira, how he received Vidura.
泡泡在这里描述了这个尤迪斯蒂尔如何展示恰当的行为举止，他款待阿尔朱纳。
Vidura had come home suddenly without warning. He returned to their home after many years.
而维多拉经过很多年以后，也没打声招呼，突然就回家了。
So Maharaj Yudhisthira immediately arranged for Vidura to to have, what does it mean? What did he do first? They had rest first. No. Well, he offered them sitting accommodation.
Vidura安排一个舒适的住处。
It mentions actually in the purport, Prabhupada said first he was able to take bath.
泡泡就说了，他安排他先沐浴、更衣。
Because naturally he's not coming by flight, or he's not coming in the bus. He came walking.
因为维多拉回家时没有坐飞机，也没有坐大巴，是走着回来的。
So first thing was that he would take bath to refresh himself.
所以到家以后第一件事。 要沐浴，让自己身体变得放松、舒服一点，清洁一下。
Just like here in Kathmandu, you know, it's a lot of dust, quite dusty everywhere. So when we go out, you come back, you want to refresh yourself.
就像在这里加德满都，就是到处都是灰尘。你出去以后，回到家里，你让自己清洁一下，放松一下，清新一下。
So Vidura had come from a very far away place. He'd been traveling all over the holy places, all over India, and then he's coming back to Hastinapur.
而维多拉呢是大老远了，拜访了整个印度的圣地，所以他就才回到了Hastinapur.
So first thing was he wants to bathe himself and maybe change his dress.
好了，所以他回来后第一件事儿。 要沐浴，啊，可能更衣。
And then fed him sumptuously.
啊，那下一步什么就开始吃，吃的老丰盛了，老好吃。
It's very important for us in the, when we run a Krishna conscious center that we arrange nice reception for the guests.
所以有非常重要的一点，如果我们在 Krishna 中心要开庙开中心的话，有个重要一点什么，客房得弄好，客人 得招待好，这是很重要的。
When you come, the visitors coming to the center, we should know how to receive them.
所以我们也知道，一旦客人来中心，我们应该怎么盛情款待这些客人们。
And when people are well received, then it creates a very nice impression on them.
如果客人给伺候好了，这客人对我们的感激、欣赏之情就大增了。
Modern,
老欣赏我们。
In the modern civilization, we don't have this culture.
在现代社会可没这种文化。
If somebody comes, we'll say, "Why are you coming here?"
人们一来，你跟他说啥？你为啥到这来？你干嘛来了
？What do you want? Why you come? Who told you you could come here?
我没让你来，你来干嘛
？But there's a saying in the traditional culture. It said that the uninvited guest.Should be treated like a demigod.
在一个文化，那古老文化有一个谚语，就是说，无论谁到你家，你就把他当作半神人来伺候。
And we see in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there's nice examples of how people would receive guests.
这个在圣典薄伽瓦坛中有些例子来展示如何非常盛情的。招待来的客人
Just like Maharaj Ranti Dev was a very wonderful example in receiving guests.
就像Ranti Dev Maharaj, 他是完美的招待客人的典范。
Right, he would as described in the Srimad Bhagavatam how on one occasion he and all of his family had been fasting for many days.
就像瓦坛中非常好的描述了。原地这个和他全家都在戒食。
And then a big feast was prepared. They were going to break their fast.
然后打破戒食的时候，丰盛的大餐准备好了。
But suddenly a brahmana came to visit them.
突然，一位婆罗门到访了。
And so the brahmana was invited to take food, and he took half of the food that was prepared.
所以既然他是不速之客嘛，既然到访了，就得有吃的。
And then the brahmana took food and left. And after the brahmana left, then another guest came who was a sudra.
当然，这个婆罗门吃饱了以后走了。他刚走，后脚又来了一个sudra。
So he also took some food.
这sudra来也得有吃的呀，他又吃了一顿。
And after he left, then another man came with some dogs.
这个苏哲吃完走了以后，又来了一位。他不仅他来了，还牵着一条狗来了。
And the man with the dogs, they took almost everything that was left.
然后呢，这狗和客人，这第三个人啊，把剩下那点大餐全吃光了。
There was only a little water left.
只剩点水了。
And then a yavana came, an untouchable person came, and he requested.
然后那个叫亚瓦纳不可触碰的人他来了他也要这个水喝
Maharaj Ranti Dev said this is my greatest pleasure to give to feed all my guests
Ranti Dev 说哎呀我太高兴了给我们回国的客人都吃这些东西我感到特别的喜乐
I just want to sacrifice whatever I have for the service of others
所以我这么去招待别人服务别人这是我的祭祀牺牲
So Prabhupada I remember in the beginning of our society Prabhupada instructed all the devotees how we should receive guests
所以泡泡在早期建立中心的时候他教奉献者如何盛情款待客人
He said, a guest comes to the temple. He said, the first thing is we should try to give them a nice sitting place.
Papa 说客人来了后我们要做的第一件事先给他好座位让他坐得舒服。
Right. Of course, in our ISKCON temples, we don't have a lot of furniture or big armchairs for people to sit in.
当时啊，当然在早期啊，我们奎神觉中心呐、啊，没有家具、沙发，也没有长椅子。
But we'll put a mat out or some carpet or whatever, and put something on the floor and invite them to take a seat.
但是呢，我们在地板上可以放一些垫子，让客人坐。
And then we offer them, should offer them some nice foodstuffs.
然后下一步，好吃的端上来。
There's a letter written by Srila Prabhupada in the year 1977.Prabhupada wrote, and he had, this letter was to be sent to all the centers around the world.
Prabhupada in 1977年给全世界的庙宇写了一封信。
And Prabhupada in this letter, he instructed that every center must prepare food and keep it ready for guests when they come to visit the temple.
Prabhupada 在信中给出训示，所有庙宇中心必须随时都有吃的，客人随时来要随时有吃的。
And Prabhupada instructed what they should cook. He said there should be halwa and puri and sabji and pakora.
泡泡训示给客人准备什么吃的呢？pakora, halwa,
puri
and sabji, 这些都要有。
And he said, Prabhupada said, you keep it available. Any guests come, you can immediately feed them.
就是说你中心呐、啊，每天随时要有这些东西。客人一来，这些东西都得端出来。
He said, Krishna is not a poor man. Krishna can provide.
完了，说到 Krishna 不是一个穷人 ，Krishna 不是穷鬼，他啥都有。
And when people come to our centers, they should be properly received.
所以客人一到中心，到访中心一定要得到恰当的欢迎招待。
If Prabhupada said if the food is left over at the end of the day, there's no problem. The devotees can always take.
好了，这个食物、啊、到一天的结束时没人吃了，奉献者自己照着吃了算了，使劲照。晚上就这份了，自己消化。
And of course, if for some reason you don't have food.Then at least you can give someone a glass of water.
如果当时情况确实什么吃都没有了，那你至少给客人端一杯水上来。
And if you don't have water, then at least there should be some nice words.
如果当时中心连一杯水都没有的话，应该干什么呢？至少说点好听的话给客人。
This is how to receive guests.
这就是招待客人的礼仪和方法。
Right. We should know how to speak words which are pleasing to people.
大家一定要学会怎么跟客人说好听的甜美话语。
In Bhagavad Gita, this is described as the mode of goodness. Words in the mode of goodness.
佛家梵歌描述是善良形态中的话语，说好听的话是善良形态的话。
In this age, we're very expert in speaking harshly and nastily, insulting to others.
在这个卡利年代，人们都特别的擅长说刺激人的话、尖酸的话、批评人的话，都特别擅长，都老会说。
But we should learn how to speak nice words, pleasing words, comforting words to people.
但是呢，我们一定要学会如何跟别人说娓娓动听的、舒服的、悦耳的话语。
Prabhupada also when Prabhupada was asked, "What is the duty of householder people?"
有人问帕帕，居士结婚的人的职责是什么
？And Prabhupada said, "Whenever you cook food." After the food is prepared, then you go to the door and you call out, "Food is now prepared in my house. Anybody who is hungry, please come and eat."
帕帕回答说，居士的责任是，在家里做完饭，准备饭以后，到门外就开始喊，有没有谁饿了？有没有谁没吃的？到我家来吃吧。
That this is how you observe the principle, the duty of grihastha life.
这就是贵哈斯塔居士生活所要遵循的规范原则。
you don't want to be selfish.
你不应该居士不应该那么自私。
We want to be generous and give to others.
居士应该慷慨大方，随时给别人东西。
So in this purport, it's mentioned that even if the enemy comes to your home, you should receive them nicely.
要旨中提到，即使你的敌人到访你家，你也要盛情款待。
Just like during the battle of Kurukshetra, they would fight during the day, but at night they would associate and mix together as friends.
就像在库如之野，白天打仗，晚上像哥们一样在一起聊，像朋友一样在一起聚会。白天打，晚上吃朋友。
They could go to each other and.During the day, they may be fighting and trying to kill each other, but at night, they would associate together just like they were friends.
白天互相残杀，就像要杀了对方；晚上像朋友一样互相的联谊交往，就聊，像朋友一样晚上。
And if the enemy comes, we should give them this nice etiquette, offer them food, give them a nice reception.
所以啊，这个敌人到我们家呀、啊，要盛情款待，给好座位，给好吃的。
When we observe this etiquette, then it brings very nice results. It creates very nice feelings among people.
如果我们遵守这个礼仪的话，我们就能得到好的结果，能够让别人的别人的心情或者赞美增多。
And some of our ISKCON temples are managed like that.That very successfully, they have people appointed to be at the door of the center, and whenever people come, they will take care of them.
在我们中心的管理就获得了成功。
No, they will put men, they will appoint people to be at the door of the center.
我们在魁省自觉的庙啊，中心就这么做，大获成功。他们会安排人。在门口来了以后就是迎接安排人在门口接
and when the guests come then these people are there to take care of them
然后人一来就开始细心照料这些客人
they will take them around show them the temple
然后就领他们到周围的庙的周围去参观
and they will explain what activities are going on
然后向他们解释我们这儿的活动是什么
So, this is all part of Vaishnava etiquette.
这就是 Vaishnava 礼仪的一部分。
And just like here at this center, you're getting tour groups coming, different buses are coming with the tour groups.
就像在这里中心，大车来，有分两个组。嗯 ，tour group.
No tour.旅游
旅游有两旅游车。
Yeah, they come, so they come here.
他们就带旅游车就带人来到这儿。
We should take them around.
然后人到这以后下车就带他们在庙里转。
Receive them nicely.
然后非常好的迎接他们，款待他们，接待他们。
Some places even they will give everybody who comes they give them a flower garland.
甚至有的中心客人一来都给客人带花环。
Put some sandalwood paste on their head.
把檀香浆涂在额头上、脑门上。
This is how you receive a guest.
这就是欢迎客人的方法。
And when you receive people in that way, then perhaps people will feel very much obliged. They'll feel very much grateful.
然后你要以这种方式招待客人的话，客人感觉什么？感觉特别的，就是感恩戴德呀，就特别的那种满意。
So we see Srimad Bhagavatam. It's not only teaching philosophy about God, knowledge about the soul, but it's speaking also here very practical, important points about behavior.
你看《博伽瓦坛》不仅仅讲的是神的科学、哲学，有关灵魂的知识，他还讲非常实际的practical
behavior.
他还告诉我们一些实际的行为举止的方法。
Right. What should be the proper etiquette?
就是
dealing with others.
对，他就教我们如何跟别人打交道，那个礼仪都教我们了。
In the modern society, living in big cities, people live in fear.
对现代社会，住在大城市的人都感到非常的恐惧、恐慌。
They're afraid to open the door if the knock comes at the door.
对大城市的人在家里都不敢开门，家门都不敢开，都闭着。
They have a little hole in the door.
完了，在门上弄了一个眼儿。专门看别人是谁来的。
Yeah, they look who's up there, who is it?
一敲门一看眼儿，谁来了？我得看一下。
Who's coming to my door?
谁也来到我的门
？Cameras, cameras everywhere.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
到处都有那个摄像头。
So we see how the Vedic culture is quite a different situation.
大家看一看，韦达文化和现代有多么大的不同啊！
So Vidura has come to visit, and all the family members and relatives, they all came to receive him.
你看，维杜拉一回家，所有家庭成员、亲朋好友、七大姑八大姨全来迎接他来。
And they're all offering their obeisances, and then Vidura is embracing them.
然后呢，他们都来顶拜维杜拉，维杜拉一一的拥抱他们。
So Vidura took his bath.And then he was given a very nice feast.
然后呢，维杜拉沐浴完以后，大餐，美味的，好吃的，大餐端上来了。
And then he's feeling very comfortable.
完了，维杜拉感到舒服极了。
And then Maharaj Yudhisthira and Vidura ready to talk to each other.
然后尤迪斯利尔马拉也才开始准备跟维杜拉聊天了。
There must be some reason why Vidura has come.
哎，他知道维杜拉回来肯定带着一些目的和原因回家的。
Maharaj Yudhisthira wants to know more about where's Vidura been all these years.
因为尤迪斯蒂尔玛也很渴望知道这些年维杜拉在哪里混的，混得怎么样。
What places did he visit? Who did he meet?
然后他想知道你到哪了，遇到谁了，咋回事，他就想了解一下。
But if Maharaj Yudhisthira had immediately confronted him, if he'd immediately said, Where have you been? What have you been doing?
尤迪斯利尔，维杜拉回家时，尤迪斯利尔并没有马上问什么，你去哪了，你遇到谁了，他没有马上这么问。
If he had done like that, then it would have been a very different mood.
如果这样做的话，当时那个心态呀、和现在就不一样了。
But Maharaj Yudhisthira, first of all, took care of him. He pleased, satisfied him, refreshed him, made him feel comfortable and relaxed.
尤迪斯特首先做了一个什么？就先照顾他，给他提供一个舒适的。环境，让他洗好身体，吃好喝好，让他变得舒服以后，完了再说。
Then he's ready to talk.
然后才开始准备聊天。
So this is etiquette, Vaishnava etiquette.
这就是 Vaishnava 的礼仪。
We should appreciate this etiquette. We should learn.How to practice all of this etiquette.
所以我们大家一定要理解这个万纳礼，一定要学这个万纳礼，应该学会如何的去做。
There's a nice example of Vaishnava etiquette in the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita, 彩檀尼亚经很好地描述了这些万纳礼。
Sanatana Goswami was living on the beach with Haridas Thakur.
Sanatana Goswami, 在哪住呢？在海滩上和哈利达斯塔库一块住。
Because Haridas Thakur, he was a Mohammedan, so he cannot go into the Lord's Jagannath temple.
因为那个哈利达斯塔库是属于穆斯林家庭来自于，所以他不允许进入加格纳特的庙。
And Sanatana Goswami, he was born in a Brahmana family, but he had been working for the Mohammedans.
但是 Sanatana Goswami 他是出生在婆罗门家庭，但是呢他为穆斯林政府干活出力。
And when he was working for the Muslims, they gave him a Muslim name.
因为他为穆斯林干活，他就得到了一个穆斯林的伊斯兰教的名字。
So he also could not go in the Jagannath Puri.
所以他也不被允许进入加甘纳特庙。
So they were both living on the beach.
所以他俩就在海滩里头混得住了。
And Lord Chaitanya was living near to the Jagannath Puri temple.
而主彩潘尼亚住在离加甘纳的庙不远的地方。
Right, and the home of Tapanamis. No, whose home was
that?
No, not Sarvabhauma. Whose home was Lord Chaitanya living? Who gave a room to Lord Chaitanya? Anyway, where at the place where Lord Chaitanya was living, Lord Chaitanya called one day. He wanted to see Sanatana Goswami.
他就彩丹亚就住在那儿。有一天呢，他想叫 Sanatana Goswami 来。
So Sanatana Goswami had to decide which way to go to see Lord Chaitanya because there were two paths.
Sanatana Goswami 就开始想了，我应该走哪条路？因为当时他有两条路可以选择。
Now one path was to go on the beach.But the beach in the middle of the day is very hot. You know, the sun in Jagannath Puri is very strong. And Puri, it doesn't get too cold there. And especially in the summer, the sun is very strong and the sand gets very hot and it burns your feet.
有一条路就是 Sanatana Goswami 得从海滩那边过去。但是当时在加格纳普里不是很冷，尤其夏天太阳照射特别厉害，那海滩的沙子都特别烫，烫脚。
Just like if you go on the Parikrama, the Vrindavan Braja Parikrama, in the beginning, at the beginning of Kartik, it's very hot, and you're walking barefoot, you can get blisters on your feet.
就像在你绕拜这个 Vrindavan Braja 的时候。在卡尔蒂卡月达姆达尔月刚开始，如果你光脚去绕拜的话，那把脚就给烫熟了。
So walking on the hot sand in Puri for some distance, you will get blisters. It will burn your feet.
尤其同样在加格纳的普里海滩沙滩上，白天如果你走一段路的话，那脚就得熟了。
But the other path to go and see Lord Chaitanya, you had to go in front of the Jagannath Puri temple.
但另外一条路是你要不走海滩，走这条路的话，你必须要经过加格纳特庙的前门。
So which path should Sanatana go on?
但就想 Sanatana Goswami 到底走哪条路啊？
Who's going to go in front of the temple? Who's going to go along the beach?
谁能走在加格纳的庙的前门？谁能走在这个海滩上
？Right, put your hands up.
你们让你们选的话，谁走主加格纳的那个庙前面举手，谁走海滩呢？举手，谁走海滩就一个，谁走加格纳的庙从那边过去举手，两个，其他人都不走。
他们就不走，
他们不走。海滩家叫你过去，你居然不去。走海滩的举手，走加格纳庙前面的请举手。
So Sanatana Goswami, he took the path along the beach.
结果 Sanatana Goswami 他选的是什么？走海滩，即使脚被烫熟了也走海滩。
So Lord Chaitanya asked him when he came, he said,Oh, how did you come? Which way did you come?
然后他一见到主彩丹尼亚，才能问他：“你是怎么来的？你走哪条路啊？”
And Sanatana said, "I came along the beach."
他说：“很神的工人回答说，我从海滩那边过来的。”
He said, "Oh, you must have burnt your feet on the hot sand."
哎呀，沙子那么热，一定把你脚烫熟了吧
？He said, "Why did you come that way?"
你为什么走这条路呢？
And Sanatana said, because if I go in front of the temple of Puri, there are many people serving Lord Jagannath there. And if I touch them, if I brush against them with my body, I'm very low birth and I'm very contaminated. So it would be not good.
他就说了，可能他跟他说，如果我走在加格纳的庙的前面的话，前面有很多人正在服务主加格纳的，而我是一个低流的人，不可触碰的人，他们一碰我的话，那都全被我污染了。
So I did not want to give any to cause any contamination for the people serving Lord Jagannath.
我可不想污染那些服务主加格纳特的人。
So I came on the sand.
所以我从海滩那边过来的。
Oh, Lord Chaitanya said, "Oh, very." It said, "One who this is very nice. One who knows the etiquette, then he is blessed with Krishna consciousness."
哦，这太好了！任何遵守拜斯纳瓦礼仪的人，都将得到主 Krishna 的祝福。
Jai Shri Radha Govinda Hari Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Gornitai Ki
Jai.
So.The Vaishnava etiquette was very important to Lord Chaitanya, and he praised Sanatan for following the etiquette so carefully.
所以这个拜纳瓦礼仪啊，对财坛家来说特别重要。他就特别赞美了沈南，表扬了沈南台哥斯瓦米，非常小心翼翼地遵守拜纳瓦礼仪。
We had experience one time. I remember Prabhupada coming from Calcutta to Mayapur.
我还记得经历过一件事儿，帕布帕德从加根从加尔各答去马亚普。
So Prabhupada would always take his breakfast halfway along the road between Calcutta and Mayapur. He would stop for breakfast. There was one little garden where there were some mango trees, and Prabhupada would stop there and he would go and sit there and have his breakfast.
从加尔各答到马亚波的走到半道，泡泡要荣耀早餐。完了，那个有一个花园，花园里有芒果树，泡泡的就住在那儿，要荣耀早餐。
So one year, I remember I was staying in the Calcutta temple, and there were many sannyasis came, and we had a fleet of vans, vehicles to go.And Prabhupada had his car, and we had a fleet of vehicles with the sannyasis and many brahmacharis, and we all went following Prabhupada's car to go to Mayapur.
当时啊，我正在加尔各答庙，服务正在加尔各答庙，当时呢还来了一些泡泡的sannyasi门徒，所以呢，他们给泡泡坐了一个小轿车，用了一个唯一一个车，就大巴van的那种货式的大。或者完那个车呢，坐着塞亚西门徒，后面还有一些车坐着斋首僧，他们都跟着前面的泡泡的小轿车一起去往玛雅普。
So when we stopped for breakfast, we made first of all arrangement for Prabhupada. Prabhupada sat down, and all the devotees served Prabhupada his prasadam.
然后呢，泡泡荣耀的时候，先安排泡泡吃早餐。好了，所有奉献者都先服务泡泡德，安排他吃早餐。
After Prabhupada took his prasadam, then we got all the sannyasis to sit down, and we served all the sannyasis their prasadam.
然后泡泡吃完早餐以后，下一个安排谁呀？sannyasi门徒开始让他们吃早餐。
And after the sannyasis took prasadam, then all of the other devotees we all took prasadam.
然后 sannyasi 门徒吃完早餐以后，再安排其他的奉献者吃早餐。
And Prabhupada commented, he said, "Oh, this is very nice." He said, "When you follow the etiquette properly, then certainly Krishna is present."
完了，泡泡说：“哎，这么做特别好。”就是非常小心正确的遵守拜纳瓦礼仪，这个礼仪之后 Krishna 就被取悦了。
So Vaishnava etiquette very important.
所以拜纳瓦礼仪啊特别重要。
Now there's an interesting thing took place in Lord Chaitanya's pastimes.
但是在彩坦尼亚逍遥时光中有一个有趣的事。
Lord Chaitanya was initiated by Ishwara Puri.
Chaitanya is by Ishwara Puri 启迪的。
Now Ishwara Puri had two servants who were with him, who were also his disciples. One was called Govinda, and the other one was I forget the name of the other one. Anyway, one was called Govinda, and when Ishwarapuri was leaving the body, Ishwarapuri told Govinda, I want you to go and serve Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
伊萨普瑞有两个门徒，其中有两个仆人，其中一个是狗温达。在伊萨普瑞临终前，他就告诉狗温达说，我想让你去服务 Chaitanya。
So Govinda came there to Puri and told Lord Chaitanya, I've come to serve you.
而狗温达就去了加甘纳的 Puri， 告诉 Chaitanya 说，我来服务你来了。
But Lord Chaitanya said, no, he said, you cannot serve me, you're my god brother.
而主宰说，
I cannot take service from you.
而 Chaitanya 说，你不能服务我，因为我们俩是神兄弟，我怎么能从那里得到服务呢？
Yeah, we're both initiated by the same spiritual master. How can you be servant of me?
我们俩都是接受同一个领导师启迪的，我怎么能接受你的服务呢？
But he said,The Lord Chaitanya said, this is not good etiquette if you serve me because you're my god brother.
主禅说，这不是礼仪，你服务我，这不是外拿礼仪，因为我们是神兄弟。
But then Govinda said, well, it's the order of the spiritual master.
Govinda 说啥，这是我们灵性导师的命令，所以我来了。
So that was more important than any principles of etiquette.
所以有比礼仪更重要的规范原则。
Must follow the order of the spiritual master.
比礼仪更重要的原则是遵守执行灵性导师的命令。
Even if it may seem to be against the etiquette.
看起即使这个命令看起来违背了歪纳瓦礼仪，你也要做。
Okay. Any questions?
大家有问题吗？
You people are not very good in giving questions, I see.
Not question, but even 50 years back, in Nepal also there was a tradition that no houses had locks. And all the houses were burning fire all the time, 24 hours. Fire was burned in the house. So that for the next day, I mean, we had no matchsticks.So fire were kept
the fire burning.
Burning throughout day and night.
And
whenever the people came, and there were no shops, so you had to go to some other house. And they would be paid very nicely with the best food.
Was the fire for cooking or for heating?
No, it's for fire for cooking.
For cooking.
Yeah, the first thing, I mean, for the next day,to have the fire was a difficult thing. So people, whenever they used to travel, they had to go to the houses. Houses were without locks. And people were given quite nice food. And even if they were not allowed to have a complete bath, at least washing the legs and hands and face.Five things we say. One, two, three, four, and five. So this was given the tradition.
So Prabhu here, his son is a devotee in Bangkok. And his son is in charge of one of our centers in Bangkok.
This Prabhu's son is a devotee. He's in Thailand.
Now his son.
Yeah, 对，帕布的儿子是奉献者，现在在泰国。
Yeah, so he lives here in Kathmandu. He is telling us about 50 years ago in Kathmandu.
他的帕布住在这个加德满都，他在加德满都都住了五十年。
And his whole life he's been living.
他一生都在这住了加德满都。
He's telling about up to 50 years ago.
他讲的是五十年前的事儿。
All right, he's telling how in the no door was locked.
在那五十年前，这个加州满都，人人家门都不上锁的，都不锁门的。
Because nobody felt any need to lock the door.
因为那个时候五十年前，这里人想什么？没必要上锁，锁门没必要锁门。
And he said every home kept the fire burning.
而且呢，那年代每个家都有火，就始终点着火，每家都点着火。
Because they didn't have matches or things to light, they didn't have lighters and things. So they just when they had a fire, they kept the fire burning all the time.
因为那个时候家的满都没火柴，没打火机，所以要想烧火的话，就像那个火始终着着，要用火就直接用。
And that fire was for cooking.So that any time somebody came, you could cook for them.
而那个点那个火就用来做饭了，谁来进屋都可以用那个火做饭。
We went to his house just a few days ago.
几天前我们去了帕布的家，爬山上的家。
Rajendra, Kamalamurti, and some other devotees, we all went.
Rajendra, Kamalamurti, 几个少数奉献者。
And when we were going to his house, we went on the back path through the up and down the hills through the jungle.
去他们家的时候得爬山，穿过丛林去他们家，在山上。
And while we were on the path, we saw ladies collecting dry wood for cooking, for making fire.
我们走在路上半山腰的时候，就看见人在山上这个捡柴火、背柴火回家去烧火。
So even today, there's people still, they cook on firewood.
所以当时现在这个人呢，山上人还爱用木头烧火做饭。
So he was telling how every home, they kept the fire burning. Anybody came, they could cook for them.
所以那个年代，五十年前的人们在家里都点火，方便任何人来，想做饭就随时可以做。
And they had water, usually the water, you know, made not so easy to take full bath.But they would give enough water to wash the legs and to wash the hands and face.
那个年代呀、啊，那水呀、啊、没那么多，不能全身沐浴，怎么办呢？他就用水呀、啊、沐浴两个脚腿，完了两个手和脸就行了，五个地方，身体五个地方就冲一下就完，点一点就完事儿。
This was the culture.
这就是文化。
Prabhu.Prabhu is saying that although the government here is communist, but still they have respect for the holidays and they have a public holiday, whole country, for Janmashtami and Shivratri and Ram Navami. He said yesterday was also a holiday.
Oh, 就这个国家尼泊尔啊，是它的政府是共产主义的政府。虽然是共产主义政府，他们也尊敬这些所有的节日，比如说会上显现日啊，西瓦拉水显现日，那个昨天那个 Rama 显现西瓦那 Rama 南妹，他这个政府也特别尊重这个节日，也要把它当成一个公众的一个节日来庆祝。
Some what kind of person?
Envious.
Envious, okay.
This person came to our temple with some bad motivation. So then how we can receive him? How we can welcome him?
就是说经典中说我们要招待朋友甚至敌人来我们家我们也要盛情款待。但如果一个嫉妒的人、如果嫉妒的人来到我们庙中心来我们家我们如何去接待这像这样嫉妒的人呢充满嫉妒之心的人。
Well, if he's coming here, then still we have to receive him.
像这样的人，既然如果来了，我们还得接待他们。
Right, he may be envious, he may say, but he can be changed. Envious people can also be changed. If you give them a lot of love and care, you can change their heart.
这样的人虽然充满嫉妒，但这个嫉妒的人和是嫉妒是可以改变的。如果我们给他更多的爱和关怀的话，他们的嫉妒之心可能会发生变化。
Of course, if he begins to become offensive, if he starts to speak blasphemy and be offensive, then we don't associate with such people.
但如果有的人就是非常的就是冒犯的，充满亵渎的说的话，对这样的人我们要小心，不要和他联谊。
Right, we don't want to give them more opportunity to speak more blasphemy and more offenses.
我们不给他们机会说那么多亵渎冒犯的话。
But at the same time, we can offer them some prasadam if they want.
但同时呢，我们还给他们什么？他想吃什么菩萨呢？我们就给他供应。
We can give them a seat. We can give them a glass of water.
我们可以让他给他座位坐，也可以给他一杯水喝。
We don't need to hear from them.
但是我们不听他们说什么，不要听他们的。
We don't need to talk much with them.
我们不要和这种人说太多的话。
If he's going to argue and be offensive, then it's not good to waste our time.
如果你跟他争辩呢，他更多的冒犯呢，那纯属浪费我们宝贵的时间。
But you can have kirtan.
但是我们可以 kirtan.
Right? You just have kirtan.
我们就 kirtan.
When Prabhupada was in Japan, and somebody was speaking about all Mayavadi philosophy,Then Prabhupada told the devotees, start the kirtan.
Prabhupada 去日本的时候，遇到那些那个分根主义者大讲分根主义哲学，Prabhupada说对门徒说了一声，开始 kirtan.
The impersonalist, he was trying to give a lecture, but in the middle of his lecture, Prabhupada ordered the devotees, start kirtan.
然后呢，这个分根主义者正在讲课，讲到一半，Prabhupada对门徒说，起来，开始 kirtan.
Don't let him talk anymore. Just start the kirtan.
不要让他们再不要不要让他再说了，让他闭嘴，赶紧 kirtan.
Prabhupada said, "I could not tolerate all his nonsense, all his blasphemy."
因为帕巴说，我无法容忍他们胡说八道、亵渎之语，我再也忍受不了了，我受不了了。
So we have to sometimes take.The last resort, and the last resort is kirtan.
如果同样，我们要让他们闭嘴的最好方法是 kirtan.
Conquers everyone. Can conquer everyone.
让我去征服每个，把那个注意点都给转移。
Okay, any other question? Yes, Mataji.
人呢？人说了，变成说，在临终的时候，如果人想着 Krishna 就可以获得成功。我们在临终时想 Krishna 是 Krishna 的意愿呢，还是我们努力的结果呢？他问这个问题哈，是 Krishna 的意愿呢，还是我们努力？我们所做的努力结果
？Well, you know, one time a devotee came to Prabhupada and he said, "Prabhupada, I can't remember Krishna, but I can serve Krishna."
有一次有个门徒接近帕帕说，帕帕，我记不住 Krishna， 但是我可以服务 Krishna。
So Prabhupada told him, you just keep serving Krishna. You follow carefully the four principles and chant your rounds every day. And then at the time of death, Krishna will force himself into your mind and take you back to God.
帕帕说啊，你就继续服务 Krishna 嘛。小心翼翼地遵守我们的规范原则，念诵还是 Krishna。当你临终的时候 ，Krishna 强迫他自己，强迫进入你的心意，把你带回守身。
So we don't deliver ourselves by our practice. It's Krishna who delivers us.
我们不是通过我们自己修行练习把我们自己给拯救出去的，全是 Krishna 的仁慈和愿望才能把我们。给拯救出去的。
Right. We may do a lot of practice, but we may not be able to go back to God.
我们大家可能修了那么多长时间，大量修习，你也不一定回归守神。
But if we get the mercy of Krishna, well, we need both. Why? Who gets the mercy of Krishna? Those who practice get the mercy of Krishna.
但是呢，我们还需要修，为什么？需要两者。谁能得到归上仁慈呢？是大量修行的人能得到归上仁慈。
So we need both. We need both Krishna's mercy and we need to practice.
所以这两点我们都要。都需要，一个是归上仁慈，一个是需要我们自己的努力和大量的修行。
When Mother Yashoda was trying to bind up Krishna, the rope was always too short.
亚苏的妈妈试图把归上给绑起来，怎么绑也少了两个指头那个长度。
No, at least this, the different these two fingers, which the rope was too short, this indicate one was the mercy of Krishna, and the other is our own prank.
绑住奎桑缺两个指头这个长度代表什么意义？一个指头代表奎桑仁慈，另一个指头代表我们的努力。
So we have to do good sadhana, we have to practice, and we have to also pray for Krishna's mercy.
所以我们要做好的 sadhana 规范修习，我们也要做服务，同时要祈祷奎桑仁慈的降临。
So you do good practice, you get attract more of the mercy of Krishna.
如果你修得好，吸引 Krishna 的仁慈就更多。
We need Krishna to deliver us.
然后 Krishna 就把我们给捞起来了，就救了。
Right? In 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "I am the swift deliverer from the ocean of birth and death."
在《婆伽梵歌》第十二章 ，Krishna 说：“我才是把你从生死之殃中拯救出来的救主。”
Okay. So, any other questions?
还有其他问题吗？
Okay, so we have some prasadam here for everyone.
在这里有一些prasadam给大家了。